Hello, welcome to the Vote Voiced YouTube channel. Vote Voiced is a 501 circa 3 nonprofit dedicated to voter education, registration, mobilization, and protection. Like Vote Voiced on Facebook. Follow Vote Voiced on Twitter and Instagram. Visit the Vote Voiced website at www.votevoiced.com. Listen to the Vote Voiced podcast. Find the Vote Voiced podcast on anchor.fm.com and everywhere you listen to podcasts. Thank you for your time and support. Now for the Vote Voiced video update. Until recently, Michigan seemed safe from the kind of anti-voting legislation that has swept the country of late. State lawmakers proposed 39 voter suppression bills aimed at elections, including ones that restrict absentee voting. For example, a bill could prevent the state from certifying elections and a pair of bills that would give ordinary poll workers a simply extraordinary amount of power to restrict voting. Many voters in Michigan are headed to the polls for the August 3rd primary election. We do this free from voter suppression. Unfortunately, the following 39 bills will hinder and may prevent us from voting as freely as we do now. Our vote is our voice. And as I take a few minutes giving you a summary of the 39 voter suppression bills which the legislators may pass in Michigan, take the time to make up your own mind. So, Michigan state legislators have introduced 39 bills that restrict citizens' voting rights, harm election administration, and demonstrate a lack of knowledge of existing election procedures and law. First, let us talk about the bills to restrict voting rights. For example, SB 273 enables county canvassers or the Secretary of State to remove or prohibit drop boxes if they don't meet unnecessarily restrictive, unrealistic, and unfunded security protocols. SB 285 limits voting by mail to those fortunate enough to own or have access to a copy machine, as it requires a photocopy of ID to be included with mailed absentee applications. In-person requests would require showing ID. SB 286 bans use of drop boxes on election day, when they are most needed. Ban starts at 5 p.m. the night before. This ban would make it harder for me to vote. SB 287 bans prepaid postage on absentee ballot return envelopes. SB 302 requires voters to attest they are not registered or legally residing out of state, even though both could be true. They would still have the right to register in Michigan, which would result in their older registration getting cancelled. There is a current law that already prohibits double voting. SB 303 and 304 ban using an affidavit if a voter arrives at their polling place without ID. The bill would require those voters to vote a provisional ballot, which would not be counted unless the voter provides more documentation than is currently required by law. SB 308 requires overly specific and restrictive signature verification rules. SB 309 gives challengers stronger protections than poll workers to lengthen voting lines and enable more improper challenges that could disenfranchise eligible voters. SB 310 prohibits the Secretary of State from sending unsolicited absentee ballot applications or linking to the application on the Department of State website. SB 311 only allows military overseas, and not their dependents, to return ballots electronically using their common access card, which service members say is unreliable. The Department of Defense has not agreed to make it available for voting. Next, let's talk about bills that will harm election administration. SB 279 allows two challengers per party for every 2,999 ballots at an absentee ballot counting board and one additional challenger per party for each additional 2,999 ballots. But total ballot count is unknown before counting, and this volume of challengers could be unmanageable. SB 280 limits to 100 days the canvassing of initiative petitions, with no exceptions, but provides no funding for additional Bureau of Elections staff needed to accomplish this. SB 282 bans staff of the state's technology department access the state voter registration database, even though they built it and maintained its security. It also bans clerk staff from accessing the database while granting new access to staff from the Michigan Department of Health and Human Services who do not need access. Attempts to ban something that does not currently happen, based on disinformation that civic groups like Rock the Vote had direct access to the database, did not. SB 283 provides only 10 hours for pre-processing absentee ballots, even though that proved insufficient, and the national best practice is 7 days. This will not prevent delayed results that enable the misinformation that harms voter trust in elections. SB 284 bans local election jurisdictions from accepting non-government grants of all kinds, despite the failure of the state to fund elections. SB 289 enables state legislators to appropriate or withhold federal election funds, despite the failure of the state to fund elections. SB 290 and 291 ban nonpartisan challengers and allow all candidates to appoint challengers. Remove felony penalties for those appointed based on false statements. SB 292 and 293 require challenger training but without penalties for noncompliance. Also, ban nonpartisan challengers, who play an important role in ensuring election integrity. SB 294 requires the ratio of partisan election inspectors in each community not to be more than 2-to-1, an unnecessarily strict requirement, rather than requiring political parties to submit names or clerks to notify parties of availability. Depending on the local population, many jurisdictions have trouble finding challengers from one party or the other. SB 295 requires training election workers to match tabulator counts to voter counts hourly, which will not work if a tabulator jams or in other circumstances where the tabulator count is not up to date in real time. And is why the unofficial election night count is on the paper tally, not the tabulator screen. SB 296 increases the chances a canvassing board will fail to certify by enlarging them and requiring a supermajority to certify. SB 297 requires a canvasser from each party present during county canvass with no enforcement mechanism to ensure that canvassers show up, enabling canvassers to stop or veto a canvass by not attending. It also gives canvassers improper authority to approve or deny county clerk staff selected to assist the canvass. SB 299 requires vote counting to stop and results to be reported by noon the day after the election, creating a legal impossibility for clerks who have no authority under the law not to count all valid ballots. Even though clerks currently have no incentive not to count efficiently. SB 305 bans the name or likeness of an elected or appointed official on any election-related communication, which would require rewriting numerous forms and documents in likely every jurisdiction in the state and reduce confidence in officially produced voter education. SB 307 requires full text of ballot initiatives to be included with ballots but does not provide funding for high additional printing costs. Finally, let's talk about significantly flawed bills. SB 274 allows pre-registration at 16 years old, but only at a Secretary of State office instead of allowing youths to access all registration methods available to other citizens. SB 275 and 276 allow video recording of audits, which is already allowed, and absentee ballot counting boards, which would violate voter privacy when a ballot is found to have been submitted without a secrecy sleeve, and require the Bureau of Elections to host those videos online without providing funding to do so. SB 277 requires deceased voter registration cancellation but without clear matching criteria and protections against wrongful removal. SB 278 redundantly requires sealed ballot envelopes to be placed in sealed ballot containers. SB 281 requires the voter registration database to be updated based on multi-state records, which is already done, and to post numbers of registrations cancelled for these reasons, which are not funded and already available by FOIA. SB 288 requires the Bureau of Elections to record and livestream precinct-level audits with election inspectors from both parties present. Even though audits are already open to the public and no funding is provided for video recording and streaming. SB 298 extends county canvass from 14 to 21 days but does not enable state canvassers to continue to meet 6 days after county canvasses are completed. SB 300 and 301 establishes early voting only from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. on the second Saturday before Election Day, rather than when most needed closer to Election Day, and on multiple weekdays and weekend days and across daytime and evening hours to support the schedules of all voters. SB 306 requires the Secretary of State to post names of clerks not current on required training, but at a time when newly elected clerks are just taking office. Every voter should have the right to decide to vote or not to vote. A decision that should be left up to the voter, not an elected official. Vote in every election. Voting in every election is the action that sends the message. Voting is important to me. My vote is my voice. Thank you for your time. Thank you for being a voter. Have a wonderful day.